Yes, I'm the foodie here.
Everything's better fried.
Yes.
A gut bomb and a sack of the greasiest fries in Christendom. It's just,
because I think there's nothing wrong with making dessert your dinner or your lunch.
Nothing wrong.
Like hot tea, this has changed my world.
I'm like you, Thai hot. I want to see the face of God. I want those endorphins.
Vegetables, that's what food eats.
Okay. I'll go ahead and say,
is it good?
They have cocktails.
Good to know.
They do have very good cocktails.
I'll try that.
Check Please KC is proudly sponsored by Missouri's own 360 Vodka, greening the planet, and Kansas City Cocktails, one glass at a time.
And then there's another one at like 100.
Yeah, that place is awesome.
What's that?
888 is awesome.
Yeah, that's the one.
Hello, I'm Doug Frost, and welcome to Check Please Kansas City, the show where regular folks from all over Kansas City dine and then dish on their favorite restaurants. This is how the show works. Every week, we have three guests. Each recommends his or her favorite spot while the other two go and check them out to see what they think. This week, occupational therapist Dollywood focuses on her upper extremities to craft a safe environment for a good time in the crossroads. Stay-at-home mom Kirsten Bird says Martha Stewart cannot hold a candle next to her pick in Overland Park, Kansas. And now, insurance adjuster Chris Stinger has inspected the property, interviewed the claimants, and found Esquina in Lawrence, Kansas, irreplaceable.
Esquina's been in business since March of 2010. But we opened it with the intention of bringing to Lawrence the kind of food that we all really enjoy to eat and prepare. We serve Nuevo Latino food, traditional Latino flavors such as cactus or purple potatoes, with a twist, adding a little roasted garlic puree or adding some pickled red onions onto the dish to really make it pop.
We've got a great setting. It's not an expensive night out, but it can be a lot of fun. We have great cocktails, and it's the same as the food. It's not real expensive, but it's all handcrafted stuff and creatively and interestingly thought through.
It's a nice getaway. Kansas City has a lot of great restaurants, but if you're willing to make the 30-minute drive to get to Lawrence, sitting on our corner on the patio or inside watching the city through the windows is just a really great experience.
All right, Chris, what's your claim for Esquina in Lawrence?
It's a Mexican food restaurant, I guess how you'd broadly classify it, but they do a lot of innovative things. They use a lot of innovative and seasonal dishes. So it's a pretty neat place.
So what do you like to order when you're there?
I've ordered the El Jefe burrito a few times. It's when you're hungry, it's
a big burrito.
It is. It's a really big one. But they have tacos, and it's seasonal, but they have all kinds of different things in them. They've got chicken, pork, beef, but they also have Peruvian purple potato, cactus. There was an okra one. So it's always kind of interesting to see what flavors they'll throw at you.
And how about, what do you drink there? They have some interesting wines, they have some cool beers.
They do. I've had their horchata, which is very nice. Last time I was there, I had a Dos Equis Amber. I also had their Gringo Margarita. They've got a very nice margarita, but they've got this one for $2.50, which I think is a complete steal. And then I also talked them out of a sip of the sangria, which they make on a ledge in the window, and it's pretty good too.
Excellent. Kirsten, do you recall what you had at Esquina?
Yeah, I had the jerk chicken taco, the fish taco, the squash taco with goat cheese crema, which was really, really good.
Yeah, this is way outside, to your point, way outside the sort of
so
standard Mexican route.
Yeah. Was it squash or squash blossoms?
Okay, I don't. It had a fancier name than squash right. taco.
Yeah.
But I thought this is going to be so bizarre, and it was awesome. And the jerk chicken I thought was going to be so delicious, and it was okay. Mm-hmm. It just the horchata, like you said, calmed my mouth down.
Cooled it off.
Yeah, it was totally fine. But yeah, I loved that place. It was really good.
And how about the fish tacos? What did you think of that?
They were good, but I've had some that I thought were better, but they were still good. Yeah, but my favorite was the squash, and I can't believe I'm saying that, but yeah, the squash taco.
I applaud you for trying the menu.
Yeah.
I mean, I think a lot of people go in there. The friend that I went with, he ordered 3 fish tacos. I'm like,
he did?
Really? You don't want to try something else?
Yeah.
I mean, can you believe that? I'm like, look at all that neat stuff they have. Yeah, I'm going to have 3 fish tacos.
And that's what's great about their menu is that you could pick and choose the different ones.
Yeah,
that you could,
I like that too.
That's what I like.
Yeah, you can mix and match. Yeah, how about you, Dolly?
You know, I love the atmosphere. I thought it was the decorations, the atmosphere is really cool. I did the 3 taco choice also, and I did the jerk chicken, the fish taco, and the carnita. The carnita was amazing. It had a dollop of guac on top of it. The meat was tender, it was great. Fish tacos, I agree. Dry, not a lot of flavor. I was putting as much of that habanero stuff on there. And it probably just killed the taste afterwards. But the carnitas, I highly recommend. The jerk chicken was good. It was a little dry, but you know, the salt chips and salsa that you get with it, it was a smoky salsa, it was good too. But yeah, it was good, it was good.
Well, so what about the decor? I mean, it's kind of a, like you said, it's this, you know, corner drugstore that's been converted. Dolly, what do you think about the decor?
I love the furniture, the woodwork they had on the chairs, the table, the lights that were hanging down were unique. I mean, I think it's a great atmosphere. I really did like the decoration and stuff. I thought it was really cool. And it was great that they had a patio that you could sit outside too.
And, yeah, and Kirsten, what do you think?
Yeah, I found it to be kind of funky organic is how I described it. And yeah, the wall of windows to look outside onto the patio was awesome. Yeah, the kids menu was super easy and super cheap. Usually, it was a cheese quesadilla. So yeah, my daughter ate it up, and then tacos were just hamburger and cheese, just really easy. And yeah, they liked that too.
I think you hit on a point though. That's what I like about it the most. It's the value.
Yeah.
You can get out of there for next to nothing. I think the entrees all under $10 unless you get one of the more elaborate things. The drinks are relatively inexpensive. So, I mean, and you know, there's not. You know, you can leave a buck tip if you like, but you can get out of there pretty cheaply.
Dolly, what do you think about bang for the buck there?
You know, I thought it was reasonable. You know, each taco I think was like $3.50, and it wasn't like a skimpy little taco. I mean, they really filled it up with the meat and
yeah, so, a lot of stuff.
Yeah, I felt like I got a value for what I paid for, and you know, you get chips and salsa with it, which I was thinking buy, and they dropped us off, and I was like, did you pay for that? Did you buy that? So I wasn't exactly sure how that worked, but yeah, that was kind of nice, yeah. And
Kirsten, bang for the buck?
Yeah, it was great, yeah.
Cool, well, Chris, it was your place. Why don't you sum up Esquina for us?
I think it's quick, inexpensive, innovative food, and I mean, the Krauses, they did the Kraus dining and the other thing, and it's neat to eat at a restaurant like that where there's, you know, really neat food at a good value.
Indeed. And Kirsten?
It was a funky, hip place with great music, great food, and I was definitely surprised. And, well, yeah, I'll make the trip back.
Wonderful. And Dolly, would you make the trip again?
I would probably not make the trip again, but I'm glad I experienced it and saw it. And I do love the fact that it's a local owner. I'm all about that. So, just being in Lawrence, sitting outside, and I think the atmosphere was great. So, yeah. I think it was a great place for anyone to experience.
Wonderful. Well, you can decide for yourself at Esquina, 801 Massachusetts in Lawrence, Kansas. Their phone number is 785-856-1625. They're open daily for lunch and dinner beginning at 11 a.m. Reservations are not accepted, and the average dinner tab per person without drinks is $10. Stay-at-home mom Kirsten Bird says you'll be mother of the year when you bring home a dessert from three women and an oven in Overland Park, Kansas.
We opened our store here back in December of 2004. We are authentic bakers. Everything we do is handmade from scratch. We use the finest quality ingredients.
The recipes started, many of them, from our grandmothers. But we like to say that we kind of give them a little boost with a little more high-end finish.
We have wonderful artists.
Yes, we do. Mm-hmm. They came to us with art degrees, and they use that talent with our medium.
We started doing our baby cakes back when we first started the business. And I like to consider them portion control, but you know, two for you, three for me.
And we have all kinds of wonderful homemade drop cookies. Then all of our cake flavors come in the baby cake size, the 5-inch, which is we call the girlfriend cake, and then the 9-inch cake. And then we do a lot of custom decorating and custom cakes for events.
We're finding more and more men are coming in, and they love the pink champagne.
So, they're proud of it.
And they're very proud of it.
Kirsten, I hear you visit Three Women and an Oven as often as you would a regular restaurant. How come?
I do.
Yeah.
Because I think there's nothing wrong with making dessert your dinner.
It's nothing.
Or your lunch.
Nothing wrong with that. And it's really nice when someone else makes the dessert for
yes.
you.
Yes. No, the place is great. It's a local place. It was started by three women, of course, where they got their name.
When they found the oven.
When they found the oven.
That's good.
Yeah, yeah. And then they just expanded to the storefront, and they have, of course, several women now in their kitchen baking desserts all day long. But they have, like, these little cakes they call girlfriend cakes. My favorite is this one called the pink champagne cake. It's just delicious.
Yeah,
if,
I saw it.
It's like
I,
a girly, sparkly
I
cake.
I foolishly did not bring one home to my daughters, who were a little offended when I went, well, there's one that's pink and sparkly, and they're like,
yeah.
Duh. Sorry, my bad.
Yeah. Yeah, it's delicious. And then my kids love just the plain cookies with frosting on them, and then they have a cowboy cookie that I love and cannot, for the life of me, recreate at home. So,
what is a cowboy cookie?
It's a chocolate, oatmeal, peanut butter, confection sugar, like ice cream scoop of a cookie. It's delicious. Yeah, we go there quite a bit.
Wonderful. Mm-hmm. Chris, what do you think? What'd you have? Did you get the pink and no?
I did actually.
You
no,
got the yeah. pink sparkly thing.
My wife
You're
and I.
You're such a comfortable man in your
that's
own skin.
True. Actually,
the metrosexual cupcake.
Well, my wife went with me, and she asked them what their most popular is, and it was the pink champagne. That pink champagne was interesting. It did have a champagne flavor. It wasn't my favorite. I had a carrot cake one that was really good. Had a pumpkin one that I enjoyed. And then my wife had a sugar cookie, and she absolutely loved the sugar cookie. She said it was great. The one advice I'd give on that place is I think it's better to get the smaller ones. The large ones, the amount of frosting on them is as big as the actual cakes.
So yeah, the frosting on top of the cupcake is really kind of crazy.
Yeah, it is.
Pretty great, like crazy. A meal out of it, right?
Yeah. Well, I mean,
I think that's what you had in mind.
I don't know that one person could actually eat that much frosting.
Again, I'm thinking there's a lot of people going, "Oh yeah, yeah we could. Yeah. We really could."
See, that's what I would think too. But my wife, she cannot get enough like frosting or fudge. She has no limit for the richness. But even she couldn't handle all that amount of frosting.
Yeah, Dolly. It makes your cheeks tingle. You know?
I mean, Dolly, can you handle the frosting? Can
well,
you handle
you
the frosting?
You know what I loved about this is the fact that they had the mini bundt cakes.
Oh, yeah.
So you didn't have to get a big cupcakes. It's exact same flavors of the cupcakes, but they're small. You got the frosting on. So I got just a box of variety of them. I brought them to my coworkers, and we just sat, ate, critiqued, and loved it. But the champagne cupcake, beautiful, yeah. sparkly.
Yeah.
It was so sweet, though. Oh, my gosh. It was really sweet. But they had this chocolate, walnut, dense, I don't know what it was, like a flourless little bundt cake. It was amazing.
I haven't had that one.
And the red velvet cake, of course, was great. So I really loved it. The fact that it's a true bakery. You go in, you go to the counter, you pick, you leave. You know, a lot of places try to have a place to sit and turn it to like a restaurant or, you know, like a little
There's a couple places
bakery.
To sit there.
Yeah, but
We went in there and got our cake, and then we were going to turn around and sit in one, but it was already gone.
Yeah.
So we sat outside on
and
the curb.
I kind of like that it was
Buy
just this
newspaper.
Truly a bakery. You go in, you get your little box, and you go and and take it home. That's what I loved about it, so.
It's counter service, but how
it
do
is
they make
counter
you feel
service.
There?
Every time I walk in there, I'm greeted with a smile. I'm greeted with a, you want your usual, you know, whatever. Their service is fabulous, in my opinion.
What do you think, Dolly?
It was great. She answered all my questions. The only reason I knew about where else, like, I was like, do you have a store out to north? Because, you know, it's a little further than my 5-mile radius again. But she did tell me, like, oh, we have it at Dean and Dulico. We have it at The Mix, which is, you know, close to where I am. So it was kind of nice to know that there were other places I could go to get their desserts. And she was very informative and very helpful.
And how about bang for the buck? What do you think?
You know, I think the little mini bundt cake was like $2.35. So I was able to get just this box full of things for like $17. And they were quality desserts. I mean, it wasn't like a basic little cupcake. It was, you know, they were so pretty. And I would definitely actually order that for any special occasion. I looked on their websites. They have beautiful cakes that they can make, and it's besides just their cupcakes. And so I'll go to The Mix and get one.
Yeah, really. And Chris, what do you think about the pricing?
I thought it was fair for what you get. I mean, it's an artisanal product. The only thing that I would say is that it is kind of far down south. And although it's a great product, there are other cupcake places.
Kirsten, well, you love the place. So sum it up for us.
Okay, it's a great place. Like I said, you can make a meal out of it if you have a sweet tooth. And definitely, yeah, I recommend it for your next cake, cookie occasion, dessert place, whatever. Yeah, I think it's a fabulous place, great atmosphere, and
wonderful.
Love it, yeah.
Cool. Chris?
Yeah, good cupcakes. Go with the small cakes, and I'd get different varieties just to see what all they have to offer.
And Dolly?
I think it's decadent, and I definitely would recommend it, you know, for special occasions. And if I live closer, I would probably stop by and grab a little cupcake for $2 to $35 and be happy. And yeah, I recommend it.
Cool. Well, try it yourself at Three Women and an Oven, 14852 Metcalf Avenue, Overland Park, Kansas. Their phone number is 913-681-7672. They're open Monday through Thursday, 8 a.m. to 5 p.m., Friday until 6 p.m., and Saturday from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. They're closed on Sunday. Reservations are not accepted, and the average dessert tab per person without drinks is $16. Dry martini. There is nothing more personal than a dry martini. Okay, maybe Kansas City barbecue. But for me, I'm a traditional kind of guy. I like gin, not vodka. You know what makes it dry? Dry vermouth. Because this is dry, savory, kind of tangy, tart, fortified white wine. It helps dry out the martini. And then finally, I don't shake them. I know James Bond did, that's cool. I give them a nice, gentle stir because that way I can make my drink cold, but I don't dilute it. Now it's silky, like a dry martini should be. Well, occupational therapist Dolly Wood takes a holistic approach to her Midtown pick. Good range of motion for eating and drinking, a vibrant, colorful atmosphere at the Rieger Hotel, Grill, and Exchange.
The Rieger Hotel, Grill, and Exchange opened in December of 2010, and it's a collaboration, a partnership between myself and Chef Howard Hanna.
We're really trying to do as much with local and regional ingredients here at the Rieger as we possibly can. I don't want to do things that are too fancy and show off what we can do. I'd rather sort of get out of the way and let the food be what it is and what it's supposed to be. I think the bar program is something really unique here at the Rieger. The passion and the creativity of the bar staff is really very similar to what I'm used to from kitchen staff.
We definitely take a classic approach to making cocktails, but nothing but fresh squeezed juices, homemade ingredients. We make our own sodas, we make syrups and bitters and tinctures. It absolutely has a classic approach and a classic feel to it.
If we're cooking well, I think the dining room's happy and there's laughter and there's a good vibe in the room, and that's how we know we're doing a good job.
Well, we're an independent local restaurant that takes a lot of pride in our product and a lot of pride in providing a really good experience, and we're uniquely Kansas City.
Okay, Dolly, why do you recommend the Rieger Hotel?
Besides, the food is amazing, the atmosphere, you walk in, it feels like you're in this kind of a, you're not in the crossroads of the city. It's got this open kitchen. Everybody's so friendly. I love the fact that Howard uses such local produce and product, and he just, everything he makes is pretty much homemade there at his kitchen.
Well, aside from the cocktails that you absolutely have never tried,
I'm gonna have to put
what
on
do
my
you
list.
Like to, yeah, exactly. What do you like to have there? What do you like to eat?
Oh, if you had the Rieger pork soup, it is the most amazing soup. It's just rich, but it also has this finish where it has a little sour to it, so it breaks in that rich pork, in big chunks of pork. It's amazing.
Yeah, my mouth's watering.
Did you have that?
No, but I was, my
mouth's
watering.
Oh, my gosh, yeah.
Kirsten, how about you? What'd you have?
Oh, I had the scallops and sweetbreads.
Oh
my gosh, you guys. I don't know, I think Emily Post would have been disappointed with me because I did not want to look up for my plate. I did not want to put my fork down. It was so good. So I was so pleased to go in there. I'd been to the place when it was another restaurant before, and it was fine, but this place just, I mean, it just knocked the socks off.
They've changed the menu from the previous restaurant. The atmosphere is different.
Oh my gosh, it was awesome.
And I don't know if you noticed the floor.
Yeah.
The tile, the original tile.
I did notice that.
With the R down there for Rieger.
Yeah. Oh. I did notice that. And the service was outstanding. Like, we were there for 2 hours. It went by like that, which is, you know, kind of unusual. Mm-hmm. But I looked at my clock, I'm like, oh my gosh, it's 2 hours we've been here. It was so good. Service was great. Atmosphere was fantastic. Yeah.
Yeah. I liked it. They took the best parts of the restaurant that was there. I mean, because that's a really neat building. Mm-hmm. A really
it is
neat place.
Yeah. So what'd you have?
Well, I went there twice.
Do what you got to do.
There you go. I went there for lunch one day. I sat up at the counter, and so I was overlooking the kitchen.
Isn't that the best?
It's really fun. Yeah.
That's just watch
really
them cook.
Fun. The special of the day was a Reuben,
oh,
which is pretty standard.
Yeah.
Except this one was made with beef tongue. I've had beef tongue before in Mexican dishes, and the texture sometimes isn't the most appealing, but
the texture of a tongue.
Yes.
Right.
Yeah.
But right. They used the sous vide machine, and they cooked it for a long, long time over very low heat, and it was just, it was the most tender piece of meat. They flaked it off. Yeah, I got that pork soup too. I started out with the pork soup the first time for lunch.
Heaven.
It's the richest broth ever, but it's not overpoweringly rich. You're right, there is that bit of acidity. There's chunks of pork, and what you omitted is there's crispy pork skin.
Yes, I tried to avoid that part because, you know, if I know, I think about it, but it's
crunchy goodness.
You have to love every part of the pig.
But with crunchy the cheese, goodness. It was a Gruyere cheese.
So yeah, that kind of, yeah.
So you just, earthy, I mean, cheese, it's earthy this, yeah, amazing. What are you doing later? Because after this, I think I'm going to the Rieger. I'm having my soup.
Nice, I see why you like the place. Well, what do you think about the value of the place?
Right on the money, absolute, yeah, perfect value. I thought of it as a great date place or a great place to take your clients or an impressive place to take somebody to impress them, yeah, definitely.
How do you feel about the pricing, Chris?
The pricing was good. When I went there for lunch, I had two things. Either one of them could have been my entree, and that was very affordably priced. And then we went back for dinner. Instead of getting, you know, one big entree, I ended up getting three different things so I could try it all.
Which three things did you get?
I did get the risotto. The pear sounded unique.
Mm-hmm. Pear in the risotto?
Yeah, but the pear actually had a little bit of a bite to it. And there was a ton of the truffle.
Meanies truffle. Oh, yes. There we go.
It had a ton of truffle.
How is this bad?
How
is
this
bad? Yeah, they put it in front of me and the truffle smell wafted up. And that is one of my very favorite things. I had one of the sausages that they had made. It was a rabbit sausage. And then I had their soup of the day, which was French seafood soup. And it had seafood in it. It had shellfish. And they pureed the whole thing up. And so it was very, very intense fish and shellfish. It was very good.
Cool. And Dahlia, you had some choucroute at one point, right? Choucroute garni?
Yes.
You like,
yes.
You're a choucroute girl?
It was the Duroc pork. It was like a pork chop. And then Howard makes his own ham. And then he made a veal and pork sausage. And then heirloom potatoes with a mustache and a mustard sauce. And then the homemade sauerkraut. It was amazing. It was a lot of food for the money. That's why I think the value is so great. And everything was on the money. It was great.
How about dessert? Any dessert?
We did have a dessert. It was a wonderful chocolate dish with actually a horchata ice cream on the side.
Mm-hmm.
And there was some fleur de sole. It was just very tasty.
And Dahlia, any desserts?
I didn't have dessert. I go for the appetizer. I had a steak tartare, an oyster tartare instead.
Well, Dahlia, it's your restaurant. Why don't you sum it up for us?
You can't go and not have a good time. The food's amazing. It's seasonal. And they have it. They know what they're doing, and that's why it's packed every night. And if they can continue what they're doing, this place is gonna just fly. It's amazing.
And what do you think, Kirsten?
Agreed. No, I can't say more or less. Agreed. Yeah.
Oh, well, I'm so glad you guys liked it.
It was wonderful. Awesome.
And Chris, you went as well?
Yeah. It was wonderful. And honestly, I would say that pork soup's probably one of the best dishes in all of Kansas City. I will drive up there.
Wow.
I mean, it was also good, but that pork soup was wonderful.
Wonderful. Well, you can decide for yourself at the Rieger Hotel Grill and Exchange, 1924 Main Street, Kansas City, Missouri. The phone number is 816-471-2177. They're open for lunch and dinner Monday through Friday, dinner only on Saturday. They're closed on Sunday. Reservations are accepted. The average tab per person without drinks is $38.
Check Please KC is proudly sponsored by Missouri's own 360 Vodka, greening the planet, and Kansas City Cocktails, one glass at a time.
So on this week's show, we featured Esquina in Lawrence, Kansas. Dahlia said they have nice-sized tacos for a reasonable price. Kristen said they serve horchata and her family loves it. Chris said it's quick, innovative, and inexpensive food. And we featured Three Women and an Oven in Overland Park. Dahlia said it's decadent and would definitely recommend it. Kristen said, why not make a meal out of the desserts? Chris recommends getting a variety of cupcakes to taste them all. Finally, we featured the Rieger Hotel and Grill Exchange in the Crossroads. Dahlia said the cocktails are worth the visit alone. Kristen said the food was phenomenal. And Chris said the pork soup was wonderful, one of the best restaurants in Kansas City. We've had a wonderful time this week. I want to thank my guests, Dahlia Wood, Kirsten Bird, and Chris Stinger. Please join us next time for three new guests recommending three of their favorite restaurants right here on Check Please, Kansas City. I'm Doug Frost, and I will see you then. And here's to a few.